westernmost shores of Puerto Rico. A perfect setting on the beach at Rincon for the World Surfing Championships.
Hi, I'm Bill Fleming, welcoming you to the World's Championship of Surfing here at Rincon, Puerto Rico. The World Surfing Championship began in 1962 in Australia. Then it moved to Lima, Peru in 64. And in 66, it moved to California. This year, it's in Puerto Rico. 2 years from now, it'll be in South Africa. So it gives surfers from all over the world an opportunity to see different waters. And this is the first time that we've ever had surfing in Caribbean waters of a championship of this nature. The true story, however, in surfing during this past year has really been in the boards themselves. And I think you can get a pretty good idea of what we're talking about when you realize that this board, nearly 10 feet long and weighing almost 30 pounds, was used less than a year ago at the International Championships in Macaha. This was the ideal competitive board. But now, look at the board they're using now. This is only 8 feet long, weighs almost 15 pounds. So it's shorter and lighter, much more maneuverable, much more sensitive. But right now, they're getting ready for the competition.
And the first of three semifinal heats, Fred Hemmings of Hawaii, the oldest of the Hawaiians in this one, along with Wayne Lynch, 17 years old, from Australia. David Nueva, a West Coast surfer. George Thompson from South Africa faces a stiff challenge here. Russ Hughes of Australia, a member of the Australian team for the last 5 years. These three semifinal heats, and then two top men from each semifinal will go into the final, so it's very stiff competition. And while they're paddling out, let me mention to you that also today on ABC's Wide World of Sports, we'll see the World Invitational High Diving Championships from Hollywood, Florida, and the National Air Races from Reno, Nevada. Just about set to go, and there is the starting gun. First man up is Hughes, Russ Hughes of Australia. You'll notice here now the waves have what they call a right break. In other words, on the surfer's right, he has green water, pursued by the white water behind him. This is an orthodox style, left foot forward, right foot back. And a good pull out for Russ Hughes. David Nueva, fresh from his victory at Huntington Beach, hoping to capture a world championship here now. You'll notice the difference. David is a goofy footer, right foot out first. Now somebody else is up, and that is Fred Hemmings up on the wave. Fred, the oldest of the Hawaiian contingent here. He's 22. He's won Makaha twice, many times a junior champion there. It has a very big board, probably the biggest board here at 8'6". And a good kick out and a good ride for Hemmings. From South Africa, our first look at George Thompson. George doing very well here. In fact, he's mastered the Caribbean waters beautifully during the week of practice. And a good ride for Thompson. 17-year-old Lynch, Wayne Lynch of Australia, the number two gun on the Australian team. Look at that, right up the front of the board. Doing a little nose riding, and as he carries right across, down in the white water he goes, still on the board and then down. Here's David Nueva. And down he goes. Nueva is down, and there goes his board in the swirling white water. That's going to cost him precious time because he's actually going to swim in now to get the board. A tough break for David Nueva. Outside now, Fred Hemmings. Notice he's a big, powerful fellow, former football player. And he kicks out. Not too good a ride there on that one. Here is Hughes of Australia. He was the first man up in this heat. Again, only two are going to be picked to go into the finals. We'll have two more semifinals in this, then we'll have the women's finals. That'll be something to see, and the men's final. Surf building really nicely here. Fred Hemmings up again. Fred getting lots of rides. Notice he doesn't ride quite as low, perhaps, as the Australian surfers. But he's a big fella and has a big board to handle. Here's Lynch. Wow, what a turn he made there. This is the youngster from Australia who likes to do a lot of S-turning. Really maneuvers that board, gets right to the heart of the wave. You'll notice what a great job he's doing, too, because he is a goofy footer. He has that right foot forward, and despite the fact that we have a right break, which kind of is to his disadvantage, he really had a wonderful ride there. And once again, Fred Hemmings who has expert judgment in picking out these waves, gets another one. This will be the last ride for him. In fact, we're running very close to going out of time here. Notice how much more maneuvering Fred is doing now. He's able to move around on the board, kicks out, has a good ride. And outside is George Thompson of South Africa. And just as he gets up, the gun goes off. He will get credit for this now, so he'll milk it for everything he can. It just doesn't close out on him. Nope. It just wasn't there. He tried in desperation to get those added points. But this heat is over, and we'll be back with the results of it in just a moment, as well as heat number two in the World Surfing Championships from Puerto Rico. In that first heat, Fred Hemmings and Russ Hughes made it to the finals. We got a word with Fred Hemmings when he got out of the water about his strategy.
Well, first of all, my first strategy is either try to be behind a person or not on a wave with it. First of all, if you're in front of a wave with this interference ruling, you might as well just kick out of the wave, because the minute you try to do something good, you're going to mess the other guy up and you lose points. I never want to get in front of anybody. And secondly, I want to catch the best wave in the set. Now, I've been watching the sets have been like two or three waves in a set. So I usually try to catch the last wave for a number of reasons. It's usually the best wave, and it will usually impress the judges more because they've seen two waves go by, they know what to look for, and then here comes a guy powering the third wave and really working it. And also, probably the worst thing of all is when you kick out of the last wave, there's not another wave down here at the end breaking in front of you so you can paddle back up.
So with Fred Hemmings and Russ Hughes finishing 1-2 in that first heat, it eliminates George Thompson, Wayne Lynch, and David Nueva. Right now we're into heat number two. Again, two will be chosen to go into the finals. Here's Nat Young, the defending world champion. He won his title in San Diego in 1966. Leads the Australian contingent, and one of the rare left breaks there. Here's Reno Avalera. Probably the smallest board in competition. Once we get a look at it there, we might be able to judge the size. They say it's around 6 feet. It's kind of hard to believe. Skip Fry is up from the West Coast. And he has a beauty. Nice wave, but kicks out. Ah, he saw the curl ahead of him and decided it was a little too dangerous. Johnson and Byrne. Byrne on the left, Johnson on the right, and Byrne goes in. Johnson stays up. Peter Johnson, and he doesn't get all of the ride that he'd like right there. These are very, very tricky. They're hard to read. Sometimes they're beautiful waves, and at other times, they're fraught with peril. Nat Young, trying to stay ahead of that white water pursuing him, doing a lot of S-turning. Young man who really has color in this wonderful sport of surfing. Right up on the nose, back, trimming the board. Look at that, right up on the heart of the wave, and then he kicks out. Good ride for Nat Young, defending world champion. This is another good chance to take a look at that board of Reno Avalera. Look at the speed that he gets with it. It couldn't be any more than about a 6 foot board. That's about 4 feet shorter than the boards used just about a year ago. These five competitors battling for a chance to go to the finals. Only two will make it out of this heat. We already have Fred Hemmings and Russ Hughes in the finals. This is Peter Johnson, West Coast surfer, Oceanside. And Alan Byrne. Alan's from New Zealand. Haven't had too much of a chance to take a look at him, but as you can see, he also is a goofy footer, right foot forward. And this surf doesn't lend itself too well to the goofy-footed surfer, because it means that he always has the curl right to his back where he can't see it. You'll notice he kind of even looks over his shoulder once in a while, and he goes in the water at the end of his ride. Nat Young up once again. You'll notice when Nat gets up, everybody on the shore, all the surfers included, even in practice, will take a look at him. Cautiously inching toward the front now. Back, trying to milk as much as he can out of it. back and forth, feeling that board, feeling the waves pounding underneath, and he goes under. So Matt Young is out, and I believe this is going to be about the last ride. This is Skip Fry up, and we're running out of time here in this heat. And that's the end of the heat. We'll be back for heat number three in just a moment. Matt Young of Australia, Reno Abalera of Hawaii, finishing 1-2 in that heat. Matt Young will be 21 tomorrow, eating a piece of chicken here on the beach. And getting ready for heat number three, Joey Cabell, a Peruvian and Macaha former champion. And together with him will be Mike Doyle in this heat. This will be a tough one. Mike from the West Coast, a real veteran. Mike Purpose, also from the West Coast. He's only 19. Corky Carroll, top U.S. surfer in 67 and 68. And Midget Farrelly of Australia, the world champion in 65. Well, Nat, while you were paddling out, you must have known what you wanted to accomplish.
I guess the whole thing to me seems to be if I can make a tighter turn than anybody else, and plus be able to do the same things that everybody else can. You know, I think that's probably the most, I don't call it a strategy. That's just the way I surf, you know. I like to bank turns as sharp as I possibly can and run straight back up wave.
So Nat Young, Reno Abalera, Fred Hemmings, and Russ Hughes have already made it to the finals, and two from this heat will make it also. Midget Farrelly, the first one up, and the surf seems to be building. Bernard Midget Farrelly, first world champion. Not getting too much of a ride there, just kind of almost feeling the wave out. Mike Doyle up. Mike has adapted his style beautifully to the changing smaller board, but boy, that wasn't a very good example of it. And there goes another board high in the air. Apparently it was Corky Carroll behind him. And both men are now chasing their boards. Corky Carroll has a long swim ahead of him. Mike got his quickly, so Mike is going on back up. Tough break for Corky Carroll, by the way. Midget Farrelly up once again. Didn't get too good a ride the first time up. Here's a nice wave, but all of a sudden it just kind of disappears on him. That's the trickiness of this surf. That's why great judgment and experience is going to pay off in a world championship for somebody here. Mike Doyle, who's had plenty of experience, up once again. Fortunately, he got his board back quite quickly. And Joey Cabell is up. Joey likes the big waves. Lived in Hawaii for a while, then skied in Aspen, Colorado, then moved back to Hawaii. And he kicks out as that wave pounds down. And Midget Farrelly up once again. Speed here. Midget using a board that isn't quite as small as perhaps some of the others. And off he goes. Here's Corky Carroll, who has now gotten his board and trying to get back out there to get some rides before the time limit is up. Mike Purpose from Hermosa Beach. This lad is only 19 years old. Keep your eyes on him. They say he's a great comer. Likes to get down low, bend his knees, work that board, nice turns. Those small radius, quick turns are what impress the judges, and a good kick out for Mike Purpose. And look at this one. Mike Doyle has got a beauty. Last one of a set. And he rides right along, just staying ahead of that curl. As we come close to the end of the third heat in this competition in the men's semifinals. Two men to make it. And Mike Doyle gets right up there. Rims nicely and kicks on. Good ride, Mike. Here's Corky Carroll. This is about the first good one that Corky's really had. Notice now, Corky is also a goofy footer with that right foot forward, and with the waves breaking right behind him, it doesn't put him in too good a spot to see what's coming, and he kicks up. And Mike Doyle once again gets up. Essing back and forth. Good crouch. Boy, for a fellow who's been in competition for almost a decade, he's really doing quite a job. Now here's Midget Farrelly and Joey Cabell right behind him. Midget tries to get this one. He does get it. And the gun goes off. That means Cabell will not get a ride. and Midget Fairley gets the last ride of this heat. So we'll be back with the results of heat number three in just a moment. Midget Fairley of Australia and Mike Doyle of the United States finishing 1-2 in that heat, and they will join Fred Hemmings, Russ Hughes, Nat Young, and Reno Abalera in the finals. Let's get a quick word with Midget Fairley on the surprising showing of the Australians.
See, I think mostly we're lucky. Secondly, we are reasonably versatile surfers. And thirdly, we don't give up easy.
And so we have three Australians in the finals. We'll be back with the women's and the men's final very shortly. Right now, let's go to Hollywood, Florida for the World Invitational High Diving Championship and Jim McKay. Thanks, Jim. Bill Fleming back here at Rincon, Puerto Rico. See the dome of the nuclear power reactor that identifies Dome Beach.
Coming up next, we have the World Surfing Championship for Women here in Rincon, Puerto Rico. So let's meet the six finalists.
First and foremost, 17-year-old Pretty Candy Chase of Puerto Rico. Janice Domorski from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Phyllis O'Donnell, former world champion from Australia. 15-year-old Margot Godfrey of Santa Barbara, California. Sharon Weber of Hawaii. And Martha Sun, also of Hawaii. The surf is building, and the girls will paddle out here getting ready for the women's finals. And by the way, coming up very shortly, we'll be having the men's finals with three Australians in the final field of six, and challenging them will be Fred Hemmings and Reno Abalera along with Mike Doyle. You know, this could be quite a surprise here in the women's. Linda Benson, who won at Huntington Beach and was second last year in the Western Surfing Association standings, failed to make the finals. And Joyce Hoffman, probably the greatest woman surfer the U.S. has ever had, did not make the finals either. First one up is Phyllis O'Donnell of Australia, and down she goes just as quickly. Here's Janice Domorski. Janice has done a remarkable job of getting into the finals. She's an East Coast surfer, doesn't get too much of a chance in this kind of water, and has really done a fine job. You'll notice, too, she's using a rather big board. It's not too maneuverable.